Hey everyone, Magic here. Welcome back. This is the first part of a multi-part video series where Zoë and I take on an exciting challenge, building a 10-inch FPV Goliath, the Rekon 10 Pro. We'll guide you through the practical decisions involved in creating not just this drone, but any large drone that you might dream up. In the second part, I'll provide detailed step-by-step instructions so that you can follow along and build your own custom Rekon 10 Pro.
This is the bottom plate. This here is the plate that goes right above. This will be the very top plate.
Just like the one we're showcasing today. Check out the video description for a list of all parts and materials, including 3D models Zoë and I created that you can print yourself. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. If you've been following my channel, you already know Zoë. But what you might not know is that she's a brilliant engineering student, diving headfirst into math, physics, 3D design, coding, and more.
The kids are getting a rep as the best pumpkin chuckers.
Their 7th annual pumpkin sling competition. The kids design a trebuchet. All these kids learning about STEM in a fun way. End of the day though, you gotta know if you're coming to chuck pumpkins.
She's also a rock and metal enthusiast, effortlessly balancing equations and guitar riffs like a pro. This build feels like the perfect project to tackle with her. And hey Zoë, you'll always be daddy's girl, right?
Who is your favorite parent?
Mama. I have to say mama.
Why?
Well, she is basically the boss. She watches every day with me. And we have a lot of mama time.
There are even bigger rigs out there, but we're not here to spray crops or survey land. FAA, please close your eyes for a moment. We're here to push boundaries, flying FPV at serious distances, skimming mountain peaks, and diving down cliff sides. To add a little flair, we've strapped on some awesome 25-volt chip-on-board lights to light up the sky at dusk. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let me provide some context before we dive into a build like this. Most pilots stick to drones with props around 7 inches max for long-range flying. So why go bigger? Prop size has a big impact on how long or far an FPV drone can fly. Larger props push more air, which means that they can carry more weight. But there's a trade-off. Smaller freestyle and racing quads are super agile and easy to tune for smooth, stable flight, usually sporting 5-inch props. In long-range FPV, we typically top out at 7 inches, which strikes a nice balance between size, weight, and agility. With the right battery, a 7-inch setup like the iFlight Chimera 7 my daughter Taylor flew in a previous video can get you 30 minutes plus of flight time.
Keep going up, 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 up.
While you gain the power to lift more weight, you start to lose a bit of that nimble control. It's harder to snap into tight turns, pull sharp rolls, or squeeze through small gaps. So, is a 10-inch quad practical? If your quad can swing a larger 10-inch prop and weighs more, you can battle heavy winds more effectively. Winter's around the corner too, and this setup should shred through heavy wind and snow like confetti in a hurricane. You might wonder, why not just grab a ready-to-fly drone like the iFlight Helion 10? And skip the hassle. That's also an impressive machine, no doubt. But building your own quad offers unique advantages, what I would tell you about most other FPV quads. First, it deepens your understanding of the drone's mechanics, making troubleshooting and repairs more intuitive. Second, it grants you complete control over the design, allowing for customization tailored to your specific flying style and needs. 10-inch drones are especially more difficult to tune. So this will add more skills to our repertoire. And that's what Zoë and I are aiming for. All right, let's talk about the quad itself. For this build, we decided on the Rekon 10 Pro frame. It offers a level of flexibility that's perfect for long range needs, whether we are cruising or pulling off powerful acro maneuvers. and all at a decent cost. The Rekon 10 provides mounting options for batteries, giving us flexibility. We can run two lightweight, short-range batteries in parallel for extended cruising, or mount a single larger lithium-ion pack for maximum range on a single charge, just below the bottom. This setup lets us optimize for either long-haul flights or shorter, more agile sessions. I do wish that the front arms were moved further outward to the sides or toward the rear in a true dead cat design, thereby removing propellers from view. We'll address that with a custom 3D printed mount, allowing us to move the FPV camera forward for a fully unobstructed view. To power our drone, we're equipping it with 900 kV iFlight Zing 2 3110 Cinelifter motors.
Those motors are sexy.
These motors are specifically designed for larger drones, offering a balance between power and efficiency. The 900 kV rating means that they spin at 900 revolutions per minute per volt, providing the right amount of thrust for carrying heavier payloads without sacrificing flight time, especially when handling varying wind conditions. They're built with high-quality materials, including a 5mm titanium alloy shaft and smooth, long-lasting NSK bearings, ensuring durability and reliability. We designed 3D-printed feet that sit just below the motors, providing a nice buffer between the carbon fiber frame and the ground. We've selected Gemfan 1050 Cinelifter tri-blade props for their durability, efficient thrust, and control. These are ideal for carrying a heavy payload while maintaining stability and providing precise maneuvering for cinematic shots. I love the feel of these too. They almost feel like carbon fiber blades, very stiff and sturdy. I definitely wouldn't want to accidentally catch my fingers between these blades. In a long-range setup like this, the focus is on smooth, efficient power use rather than constant full throttle. Stabilize the power even further, we've attached the Panasonic 50-volt, 1,000 microfarad, ultra-low ESR capacitor. This particular capacitor is very long, but sufficiently narrow. It's a much more effective buffer, storing energy and then releasing it when there are sudden spikes in power demand, which can happen during intense maneuvers or quick throttle changes, like the acro moves you saw at the beginning of this video. This helps keep the voltage more stable, reducing the chance of electrical noise or interference affecting the system. I'm particularly excited about taking advantage of some of the new ELRS radio technology in this build, Radiomaster's Gemini protocol, which lets us transmit on both 2.4 GHz and 900 MHz simultaneously using their new DBR4 receiver. With four antennas, it dominates the sky with that sort of redundancy. To maximize performance, Zoë and I have designed custom 3D printed mounts for the Radiomaster DBR4 receiver and antennas. Since antennas can lose effectiveness when too close to the carbon frame, we position each of the four antennas, two for the 900 MHz and two for the 2.4 GHz, both vertically and horizontally, giving them clear paths for signal transmission. For this build, we opted for the DJI O3 system. We're pairing it with the iFlight Albatross V2 antennas. We're using the Matec M10Q5883 GNSS and Compass module, making long-range flights far safer with better return-to-home capability. And here again, we've designed a custom 3D-printed mount for these SMA-style antennas along with the M10Q. Last, but not least, we wanted to add some flair and light up the sky. So we wrapped two 24-volt color chip-on-board light strips around the frame. These lights are incredibly bright. Given their power needs, they're wired directly to the 6S battery to draw enough current. These high-current lights are not bound to the flight controller for power, which would be a definite no-no. To control them, we're using a servo switch relay. Here's how it works. In RC setups, servos are typically used to control things like cameras or control surfaces by adjusting their position based on a signal. A servo switch relay, however, uses the same signal to control power. It's a small electronic board that reads a position signal from the flight controller, in this case, a signal at the fully up position, and when activated, it allows the high voltage from the battery to flow directly to the COB lights. Both COB lights are wired in parallel to the relay's output, ensuring that they receive power together. This quote-unquote servo is configured in Betaflight to be controlled by a toggle switch on my transmitter. While there are clear advantages for automatic navigation and flight modes offered by iNav, we're aiming for as trouble-free, smooth flying, and acroquad we can build at this size. We've chosen Betaflight 4.5 over iNav as the flight operating system. Large quads are especially difficult to tune, suffering from oscillations in flight that require a carefully thought-out pit tune. For those unfamiliar, pit tuning is like fine-tuning the drone's internal balance system. Think of this as teaching your drone how to react smoothly and accurately to your control inputs, minimizing wobbling or shaking during the flight.
It seems really stable. Okay. I'm very surprised how stable it's feeling already.
I've conducted most of my flights with a 2900 mAh 6S 120C LiPo, and I have been able to sustain about 10 minutes of flight under basic acro flying. Mounting two of these in parallel yields about 17 minutes of flight. iFlight's 8,000 mAh lithium-ion battery can yield flight time in excess of 30 minutes. But of course, at the cost of agility. Building this drone with Zoë has been an incredible journey. I encourage you to involve your son, your daughter, your sibling, or a friend in your own projects. Even if all you do is share a laugh when your masterpiece crashes into the ground.
I'm a little scared.
Me too.
Hold on.
Yeah, hopefully no one's here so I don't accidentally decapitate a 5-year-old.
The experience will be richer because you've shared it. Projects like this bring people together, blending creativity, technology, and a touch of adventure. And that's what truly makes this experience magical.
Michael, I want you to teach me how to fly a drone.
Why do you want to learn?
Because of this video.
Subscribe now and turn on notifications to make sure that you don't miss out.